Hello and welcome to the session of hemoglobin, RBC indices, PCV and ESR. Hemoglobin is an essential protein of life. Hemoglobin is a two-way respiratory carrier tetramer protein molecule present in the red blood cells. In arterial circulation, hemoglobin has a high affinity for oxygen and low affinity for carbon dioxide. In venous circulation, the relative affinities are reversed. One RBC contains approximately 300 million hemoglobin molecules. Structure of RBC. Hemoglobin comprises of four subunits, each having one polypeptide chain and one heme group. Oxygen binds reversibly to the ferrous ion atom in each heme group. The polypeptide chain of adult hemoglobin themselves are of two kinds, known as alpha and beta chains. They are similar in length but different in amino acid sequence. Alpha chain of all human hemoglobin, embryonic and adult, is the same. But non-alpha chain, they are different. They include beta chain of normal adult hemoglobin, known as alpha 2, beta 2. Gamma chain of fetal hemoglobin, known as alpha 2, gamma 2. And delta chain of HbA2, known as alpha 2, delta 2. Adult hemoglobins are HbA, HbA2, HbF and HbBAT. Is adult but it is abnormal hemoglobin, and embryonic hemoglobin are Hb Portland 1, Hb Portland 2, Gower 1, Gower 2. Now let's see some variants of hemoglobins. First we see the structural variant of hemoglobin. Structural variants are generated by substitution of one amino acid to another amino acid at the different location in globin chain gene. In hemoglobin S, it is also called the sickle cell. Glutamate is replaced by valine in the sixth position of beta chain, which gives rise to sickle shape RBC. Sickle cell disease is already discussed in detail in separate video. The link is in the description below. In HBC, the glutamate is replaced by lysine and it generates HBC crystal in RBC. In HBD, glutamate is replaced by glutamine in 121th position of beta globin chain. Most common abnormality seen in HBD is microcytic hypochromic RBCs. In HBE, the glutamate is replaced by lysine at 26th position of beta globin gene. Most common abnormality seen in the RBCs are target cells. In HBO Arab, the glutamate is replaced by lysine at 121th position of beta globin gene. Let's understand functional variants of hemoglobin. They form by different molecules attaches with heme molecule of hemoglobin. After attachment of these molecules, the function of hemoglobin is changed. So when O2 is combined with hemoglobin, then it is called oxyhemoglobin. Main form of hemoglobin seen in the arterial circulation where blood is carrying O2 from lung to tissue. The next is carboxyhemoglobin. When carbon monoxide is combined with hemoglobin, then it is called carboxyhemoglobin. Carbon monoxide is generated by incomplete combustion of hydrocarbons. When carbon monoxide poisoning occurs, it has a greater affinity to bind with hemoglobin than oxygen has, thus forming carboxyhemoglobin and reducing O2 carrying capacity and O2 utilization, thus leads to hypoxia. Acute toxicity of carbon monoxide poisoning can be lethal. The next is carbaminohemoglobin. When CO2 is combined with hemoglobin, then it is called carbaminohemoglobin. Main form of hemoglobin seen in the venous circulation when blood is carrying CO2 from tissue to lung. Next is sulfhemoglobin. When sulf group is combined with hemoglobin, then it is called sulfhemoglobin. It is a rare condition in which sulfur atom oxidize the heme moiety in the hemoglobin, making Hb incapable of carrying oxygen and thus leading hypoxia and cyanosis. It occurs in the patient taking sulfur medications or due to increase in the sulfur producing bacteria in the intestine in the setting of chronic constipation. Next is methemoglobin. When ion of hemoglobin is oxidized from ferrous state to ferric state means Fe plus 3, then it is called methemoglobin. The ferric ion is incapable of binding with oxygen and it cannot transport O2. So, increased level of methemoglobin result in the functional anemia and life-threatening event. It is a life-threatening event. Methemoglobinemia occurs secondary to toxic exposures, where cytochrome B5 reductase ability to reduce ferric ion is markedly reduced. So, this is methemoglobin. And when cyanide group is combined with methemoglobin, then it is called cyanmethemoglobin. It is a method of measuring hemoglobin in vitro. All types of hemoglobin can be converted to cyanmeth Hb except sulf Hb. Concentration of this Hb is measured by spectrophotometer with wavelength of 540 nanometer. Let's see the methods for analysis of hemoglobin. First is method based on development of color. Basic method is Sahli's or also called the acid hematin method. Second is cyanmeth hemoglobin method. Third is oxyhemoglobin method. Fourth is alkaline hematin method. Second is measurement of O2 combining capacity. Third is measurement of iron content. Commonly used methods are Sahli's and cyanmeth hemoglobin in under-resourced laboratories and automated cell counter in most clinical laboratory settings. Let's see Sahli's or acid hematin method. Principle: the blood is mixed with 10-HCl, resulting in conversion of hemoglobin to acid hematin, which is brown in color. The solution is diluted till its color matches with the brown color glass of comparator box. The concentration of Hb is read directly. The disadvantage of this method is it is a less accurate method. All hemoglobin like oxyhemoglobin and sulfhemoglobin are not converted to acid hematin. Hence, the value of Hb obtained is less than actual value. The color of glass in the comparator box tend to fade with time. And there is no true standard available for this test. It is only used in under-resourced laboratories. Next is cyanmeth hemoglobin method. Principle: the blood is diluted in the solution containing potassium cyanide and potassium ferricyanide. The latter converts the hemoglobin to methemoglobin, which is converted to cyanmethemoglobin by potassium cyanide, The absorbance of the solution is then measured in the spectrophotometer by wavelength of 540 nanometer or in colorimeter using a yellow-green filter. Advantage: all form of hemoglobin except sulfhemoglobin are converted to cyan methemoglobin. The visual error is absent, which is present in Sahli's method. Disadvantage is potassium cyanide is poisonous, and abnormal plasma proteins and high WBC count can cause turbidity that can interfere with the result. Next is automated cell counter. They are using a different technique to count hemoglobin, such as cyan-meth hemoglobin method. Next is cyanide-free colorimetric method, which is sodium lauryl sulfate hemoglobin assay. And third is directly measured from the side scatter or the spectrophotometric method. Advantage is quick and accurate. It is free from toxicity when cyanide free method is used, and standards and quality controls are available. Let's see the causes of low hemoglobin and high hemoglobin. Low hemoglobin is when hemoglobin is less than 13 gram per dl in male and 12 gram per dl in female, and high hemoglobin is when hemoglobin is more than 17 gram per dl in male and more than 15 gram per dl in female. Let's see the causes of low hemoglobin. First is decreased production of RBC or decreased utilization of iron, like nutritional deficiency, chemotherapeutic drugs, bone marrow disorders, renal disorders, chronic inflammatory disease. Second is increased peripheral destruction of RBC, like hemoglobinopathies, autoimmune hemolytic anemia, infection. Third is blood loss and increased need, like condition of pregnancy. Let's see the causes of high hemoglobin. First is dehydration, high altitude, renal disorders like renal cyst, renal malignancy, Bartter syndrome, etc. Lung disorders like COPD, cyanotic heart disease, carbon monoxide exposure, polycythemia vera, Kiesbock syndrome, and EPO secreting tumors like hepatoma or uterine leiomyoma. Let's learn about RBC indices. What are RBC indices? MCV, MCH and MCHC were first introduced by Winthrop in 1929 to define size and hemoglobin content of red blood cells. The variation in size of RBC can be quantified and expressed as red cell distribution width, also called RDW. The RBC indices measures the size, shape and quality of RBC. So first we see what is MCV. MCV is a mean cell volume, also called the mean corpuscular volume. Definition is average volume of RBC. It unit is femtoliter. The formula is MCV is equal to HCT percentage into 10 upon RBC count. Example is when HCT is 45% into 10 divided by RBC count is 4.5 million is equal to 100 femtoliter, and reference interval is 80 to 100 femtoliter. Let's see MCH. MCH is called mean cell hemoglobin, also called mean corpuscular hemoglobin, and definition is average weight of hemoglobin in RBC. Unit is picogram. Formula is MCH is equal to HB in gram per dl into 10 upon RBC count. Example is MCH is equal to hemoglobin where 12.5 into 10 upon RBC count is 4.2. So result is 29.76. Reference interval is 26 to 32 picogram. Third is mean cell hemoglobin concentration, also called MCHC. Definition is average concentration of hemoglobin in RBC. Unit is gram per dl. Formula MCHC is equal to hemoglobin gram per dl into 100 upon HCT percentage. So MCHC is equal to 13 into 100 upon 39 is equal to 33.33. Reference interval is 32 to 36 gram per dl. Fourth is red cell distribution width, also called RDW. The definition is coefficient of variation of red blood cell volume distribution, also called variation in size of RBC. Unit is in the percentage. It is derived from RBC histogram. Reference interval is 12.5 to 15.5 percentage. Let's learn the causes of high and low RBC indices. First is MCV. High MCV can be seen in the spurious conditions like red cell agglutination, hyperglycemia, leukocytosis. When RDW is normal and high MCV is found, then the conditions are liver disease, aplastic anemia and MDS. And if RDW is high and MCV is also high, then it is seen in megaloblastic anemia, MDS and secondary to chemotherapy. The low MCV. Low MCV in normal RDW conditions are seen in heterozygous thalassemia and anemia of chronic disease. Low MCV seen in the high RDW conditions are iron deficiency anemia and RBC fragments, also called cystocytes. Let's see MCH. High MCH is seen in megaloblastic anemia, hemolysis, recovery after bleeding or chemotherapy or nutrient replacement, medication side effect, alcohol, liver disease, HIV infection, hypothyroidism, copper deficiency, kidney disease. Low MCH is seen in iron deficiency, nutritional deficiency, autoimmune disease, malignancy, blood loss, thalassemia and other hemoglobinopathy. MCHC, autoimmune hemolytic anemia and autoagglutination cause high MCHC, and it is almost always spurious. Low MCHC seen in iron deficiency, thalassemia, other hemoglobinopathy and blood loss. Let's see RDW. High RDW seen in iron deficiency anemia, cystocytes, blood transfusion, nutritional deficiency or after the nutritional supplement, megaloblastic anemia, MDS, secondary to chemotherapy. Let's learn about packed cell volume, also called PCV. What is PCV? PCV is measure of red blood cell mass. An increase in red blood cell mass is equivalent in to erythrocytosis and decrease indicates anemia. This is directly measured value obtained from centrifuging blood in microhematocrit tube in microhematocrit centrifuge. The PCV is measured as a height of the red blood cell column in the microhematocrit tube after centrifugation. So this is PCV and this is plasma. In anemia, PCV is reduced and plasma are more. In polycythemia, PCV is high and plasma is less. HCT formula is MCV into RBC count upon 10. ESR. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate is a common hematologic test that may indicate and monitor an increase in inflammation activity within body caused by one or more conditions such as autoimmune disease, infection or tumor. The definition is when anticoagulated whole blood is allowed to stand in a narrow vertical tube for a period of time, the RBC under the influence of gravity settle down from the plasma. The rate at which they settled is measured as a number of millimeter of clear plasma present at the top of column after 1 hour. The unit is millimeter per hour. The methods are Westengreen method, Winthrop's method, micro ESR, automated ESR. The three stages of sedimentations are: first stage is roulet formation, second is settling of this roulet formation, and third is packing of roulet formation. Westengreen method. The Westengreen method require collecting 2 ml of venous blood into the tube containing 0.5 ml of sodium citrate. The blood is drawn into the Westengreen tube to 200 mm mark. The tube is placed in the rack vertically in position for 1 hour at a room temperature, at which time the distance from the lowest point of the surface meniscus to upper limit of RBC sediment is measured. The distance of fall of erythrocytes expressed in millimeters in 1 hour, it is called erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Most commonly nowadays, ESR is measured by automated method. In this method, ESR is determined by optical recording of difference of RBC column height before and after sedimentation in determined period of time, like half an hour. It is called modified Westengreen method. And other method is measuring kinetic of red blood cell aggregation and capillary photometry technology. ESR. Factor affecting ESRs are plasma fibrinogen level, globin level, roulet formation, RBC size and shape, settling of RBC, technical and mechanical factors. ESR increased in rheumatoid arthritis, infection like tuberculosis, anemia, multiple myeloma, Waldenstrom, macroglobulinemia, arteritis, infections of bone and joints, kidney disease, low serum albumin, lupus, lymphoma, RBC abnormality, systemic vasculitis, thyroid disease, etc. Extremely high ESR, more than 100 mm per hour, may indicate presence of infection, multiple myeloma, Waldenstrom, macroglobulinemia, temporal arteritis or hypersensitivity vasculitis. ESR decreases in hyperviscosity syndrome, polycythemia, sickle cell anemia, microcytosis, spherocytosis. So these are the references for this video. Hope you like it. Thank you.